I'm going to give you an example of two intra LT frequency cells. And in order to give that example, I will be elaborating this specific event, event A3. And the definition of the event is written on the screen, as you can see. Let's say this is cell A, and this is the coverage of the cell. And then let's say there is another cell in the neighborhood, and this is the neighboring cell. And the coverage of the neighboring cell is like this. So let's label this neighboring cell as N. So let me erase this and label it as N. And let me label the serving cell as S. So in this case, we are assuming both the cells belong to the same frequency. So let's list F1 on both of them. And on the right side, I am going to draw a graph. So this graph will be important. So let's take on x-axis, we have time, and on y-axis, we have the measurement. So let's say in this case, we are triggering the event based on RSRP, reference signal received power, RSRP. And let's say the user is standing onto the serving cell here. Now in this case, if user is standing on the serving cell here, how the coverage of the serving cell will look like? So the coverage of the serving cell I am going to represent as in red color, and the coverage of the neighboring cell I'm representing it as white color. Now the user is standing at position number A. When the user is standing at position number A, the coverage of the serving cell will be something like this, which you see I have drawn with the green color on the right side. However, let's say the user starts moving from cell A towards another position. It remaining connected into the serving cell A, it moves to another position, and this position is termed as position B. And now you see UE is moving from position A towards position B, and position B is closer. It is closer to the neighboring cell. So what will happen? The coverage of the serving cell, the coverage of the serving cell will start to go down. And since I promised I am going to draw this in red color, so let me draw it once again in red color here. So this is how the behavior of the coverage of the serving cell will be like. Initially, it is better or higher, and as you move towards the neighboring cell, the coverage of the serving cell will start to go bad. And when the coverage of the serving cell is going bad, at the same time, coverage of the neighboring cell will start to go better, or it will become more better than the serving cell. So if I have to write this mathematically in an equation, let me say MN represents measurement on the neighboring cell and MS represents measurement on the serving cell. Then what will happen is, in this case, a UE is measuring both the neighboring cell and the serving cell, and UE is not going to make a decision at this point right away saying, oh, neighboring cell is better than the serving cell and an event will trigger. No, it will not happen like this. In fact, UE will have to first satisfy an equation. And before the equation is satisfied, what happens is UE first will add an offset value into the serving cell. That offset value can be configured by the operator. Usually in practice, in field, the value for this offset value is around 1 to 2 dB. And similarly, in order to make sure that the neighbor seems to be weaker than the serving cell, it will subtract a hysteresis value from the neighboring cell. So here offset is added, and here we are going to subtract hysteresis value from the neighboring cell. So hysteresis parameters can be named differently in different vendor equipments, but the idea is the same. It will be representing hysteresis. Now, having done this, let's subtract the hysteresis, and what it will look like. It will look something like this. After subtracting hysteresis, the coverage of the neighboring cell in the graph will seem to be a little bit lower than the coverage of serving cell, but still, even after subtracting hysteresis, still it is better than the serving cell. Now at this point, you see, even after subtracting hysteresis, if you see in the graph, neighboring cell is still better than the serving cell. So at this point, UE will start running a timer. At this point, let me indicate it, this is the triggering point. Here it will trigger and a timer will start running. And the timer can be named differently in different operators. Some may call it as time to trigger. Some other vendors may name it differently. But the idea is, right now the neighboring cell is still stronger than the serving cell. So this is the equation which is happening. And if this equation remains true for how long, if this equation remains true for the whole time to trigger duration, then at the end of this timer, UE is going to conclude that event A3 has taken place. So this time to trigger can be defined as a parameter, and it is defined as a parameter by different vendors. If this equation and this behavior remains true for the whole time duration, then at the expiry of this time, UE is going to send a measurement report towards the serving cell, and that measurement report will include the specific outcome of this event A3. So it will send A3 report. And after this A3 report is received, the serving cell will decide either handover needs to take place or not. So now you know that when the handover is taking place, it's not that the UE just saw a signal which is better or stronger than the serving cell and it just started to do handover. In fact, this event A3 is the trigger between any intra-frequency handover. Once this particular event report is received, then it's the decision of the E-node B to tell the UE either to do or get ready for handover or not. And it's the responsibility of the E-node B to cover for preparation phase of handover and execution phase of the handover. But this event A3 is the equation I have written generically here. Thank you.